This morning, First Lady Jill Biden facing criticism after telling a group of Latino voters they were, quote, as unique as breakfast tacos.
The diversity of this community, as distinct as the Bogotas of the Bronx, as beautiful as the blossoms of Miami, and as unique as the breakfast tacos here in San Antonio, is your strength.
The comment came during a prepared speech in San Antonio, Texas, where the largest Latino civil rights group in the country gathered for a conference. Now, the National Association of Hispanic Journalists is responding in a tweet, encouraging, quote, Dr. Biden and her speechwriting team to take the time in the future to better understand the complexities of our people and communities.
Let me ask a sensitive question for a Chicagoan. How many Cleveland Indian fans in the house? I just want you to know that you don't have to worry, because we will get you out of this auditorium before the first pitch. So you're all good. And because I've been watching the World Series, I am aware that because Francisco Lindor stole second base in game one, everyone in America gets a free taco at Taco Bell tomorrow.
There's a powerful connection between the dollar and Taco Bell, because it unlocks a world of 20 decadent menu items from breakfast to late night for just a dollar each. 20 items for a dollar. 20 steps on the pyramid. Who's really behind this? Is it the Illuminati or the Bell-luminati? Experience the power of the dollar at Taco Bell.
We have faith in our leaders.
You owe me a new pair of glasses.
As to what becomes of it all.
President.
It really boils down to our ability to accept. We don't need pessimism. There are no limits.
It figures it would be something like this. Our nation.
And I'm all out of bubble.
Look! Oh. Look at them! They're everywhere!
I don't know. Maybe they can see.
Now hold on. You ain't the first to wake up out of their dream.
Taco Tuesday. Taco Tuesday.
No, I've never had a taco bowl at Trump Tower.
Southwest Floridians now responding to this picture tweeted by Republican presidential candidate Donald Trump chowing down on a taco bowl on this Cinco de Mayo. Trump claiming that the best Tex-Mex can be found in the Trump Tower.
Oh, but it wasn't just food he was talking about. He also tweeted out that he, quote, loves Hispanics, too.
And don't forget Taco Tuesday is coming next week. That's the day
you'll be put to sleep.
And have a great day, everybody.
You have a great day, too, President Business. Man, he's such a cool guy. I always want to hear more of what... Wait, did he say put to sleep?
Tonight. On Where Are My Pants?
There is a signal broadcast every second of every day through our television sets. Even when the set is turned off, the brain receives the input and programs.
Have any trouble getting here?
No, we made it fine.
Oh, good.
The box in every home in America, and one day the world.
In local news, Edward Nygma's 3D box has become the rage of Gotham. Rioting occurred last night at electronic stores, which were sold out. There's hardly a home without the Nygma Tech Box. Critics have claimed the box turns Gothamites into zombies, but Edward Nygma just shrugs. That's what they said when TV was invented.
Before Clinton arrived at the Smith Center, she made a stop at Tacos El Gordo in Charleston near Bruce. She gave out some hugs and took a few selfies before ordering. She also informed the media it's the place to go in Las Vegas and said everybody should try it.
What was I just thinking? I don't care.
Hi, I'm Stephen Colbert, host of Showtime's live election night special. Join me on election night from 6 feet away. Hopefully in the future, you'll have to explain to your grandchildren what that joke means. Also, hopefully in the future, you'll have grandchildren. Also, hopefully there will be a future.
Stephen Colbert's Election Night 2020, Democracy's Last Stand, Building Back America, Great Again, Better 2020, live Tuesday, November 3rd.
Don't forget Taco Tuesday's coming next week. That's the day
you'll be put to sleep.
WXYZ.
And now, folks, it's time for who do you trust? Hubba, hubba, hubba. Money, money, money. Who do you trust? Me? I'm giving away free money.
We're back now with a surprise for many Americans. Those stimulus checks from the government went out early, and some received them in their bank accounts today. Senior business correspondent Stephanie Ruhle joins us now. Stephanie, good seeing you. Why have some people received them but not others?
Jose, they are going first to people who filed their taxes previously using direct deposit. That way it goes straight to your bank account. Now, if you haven't received it yet, don't worry. They're not going out all at once, but they should be by the end of next week. And if you didn't do direct deposit, the government is sending old-fashioned checks, but that could take a few weeks.
And Steph, who qualifies?
All right. Well, almost 80% of Americans do. You qualify for $1,200 if you make less than $75,000 a year, and you get an additional $500 for any kids under the age of 17. One new development for people who don't file their taxes because your gross income was under $12,200. Well, the IRS has launched a new tool for you to set up direct deposit, and that is available at irs.gov.
And where is the Batman? He's at home, washing his tights.
Winged Battle flies through the night and finds me ready, Bob. Mask.
Mask, put him on now.
Right. And now comes the part where I relieve you, the little people, of the burden of your failed and useless lives. But as my plastic surgeon always said, if you gotta go, go with a smile.
Get in the car.
No!
Get
no,
in the car!
No! Hurry!
Like a free Batmobile cup. Or a free Batwing cup. Four cups in all, free with free refills and free cinnamon twists every time you buy a 32-ounce drink at Taco Bell. I want you to tell all your friends about me. I'm Batman.
Gotten over COVID, well, all of us can hope. At least you had your presidency's first positive results.
I beat COVID greatly. It's not as bad as they said. Time to beat a worse virus, the radical left.
Your tax return showed your success was fake news. Treats America like his business. That's why it failed too.
Of course Sleepy Joe wants to sleep on my accomplishments. The stock market's booming. He wants us to be communists.
Calling the military losers, you've truly crossed the
Speaking
line.
Speaking of lines, I hear your son does those all the time.
Condemn white supremacy. Please, man, try.
Okay, will the real Proud Boys please stand by? What have you done for blacks in your pathetic career? I've done more in 47 months than your 47 years.
If America's filled with poverty and racial tension, you should change your slogan to make America great. Depression.
So do you condone the looting?
No.
Oops, you lost supporters. We need Trump season two. Law and order.
Bad dreamers.
You have amnesia.
You're a bad leader.
Sad geezer.
Bad tweeter.
Bad speaker.
Clan leader.
Antifa!
You shut up, man.
This is Vicki Vale reporting live from Arkham City, the controversial super prison built right here in the heart of Gotham. In a few moments, Bruce Wayne will be live on stage to explain his sudden interest in Gotham politics. The infamous Playboy millionaire has never been one
to... Billionaire, Vicki. Millionaire is so last year.
ladies for such worthy causes. I personally favor Miss Natural Resources. I'd like to make her my own personal charity.
All are worthy.
Now you can say that again.
And that is Bruce Wayne's grandfather, Mrs. Cooper.
His great-grandfather.
I understand he was tapped for Skull and Bones.
Tapped for it? Sir, he founded Skull and Bones.
Where am I? Grandpa? What are you doing here?
Chris, welcome to the Skull and Bones Society. This is where the most powerful men in the world are groomed for their futures. Every president, every CEO, every douchebag named Ryan Seacrest. The Skull and Bones Society has been a part of my family for decades, and we want you to become a member.
Really? Wow, cool!
Excellent! You get your own stock portfolio, a percentage of the 9/11 Victims Fund, and the best medical care on the planet. You'll be kept as healthy as a horse.
At Taco Bell, the dollar gets you access to more. Like the new $1 stacker with lavish layers of seasoned beef and melty cheese. But how can all these layers only cost a dollar? Something's not stacking up. Is the $1 stacker reserved for a secret society or just anyone with a dollar? The answer is yes.
Why are you guys so anti-dictators? Imagine if America was a dictatorship. You could let 1% of the people have all the nation's wealth. You could help your rich friends get richer by cutting their taxes and bailing them out when they gamble and lose. You could ignore the needs of the poor for healthcare and education. Your media would appear free, but would secretly be controlled by one person and his family. You could wiretap phones. You could torture foreign prisoners. You could have rigged elections. You could lie about why you go to war. You could fill your prisons with one particular racial group, and no one would complain. You could use the media to scare the people into supporting policies that are against their interests. I know this is hard for you Americans to imagine, but please try.
To order, brethren, to receive the most worshipful, the Grand Master.
Freemasons meet as equals, and we have an opportunity to create a nation in the very essence of Masonic morality. It would be wonderfully symbolic, don't you think?
You'll be wanting to put the all-seeing eye on our banknotes next.
You think I'm taking it a bit far?
Please don't ask me questions like that, Brother Franklin. You know I cannot tell a lie.
Oh, come on, Brother Washington. Everybody lies occasionally, surely. Especially politicians.
Not me. Not even so much as an alternative fact.
But we must all be aware of fake news.
The people must be free to think what they like as well. We can have no thought police in our new society. The foundation stone of our new nation built on all those principles that we hold dear.
The plans for our new capital city already have a very Masonic feel to them, yeah.
Candidate for initiation into the order,
I'm giving them a little introduction into some of our mysteries. These two gentlemen are founding an entire nation built on our principles.
We have great promises for our new nation. You know, I wonder if other presidents after me will also be Freemasons.
Many will be. And Freemasonry will become embedded in the American culture. And the eye will appear on the banknotes.
Oh, God.
These principles will be honored with a gift from your French brethren. A gift that will be a welcoming beacon to the poor and oppressed.
This is the statue we are giving you.
It's a bit small, isn't it?
Oh, this is a maquette. The real thing is bigger. Much, much bigger.
America will produce a great many great Americans from many different walks of life and many different fields, and many will be Masons. Sportsmen! Actors! Writers! Soldiers! Filmmakers! Businessmen! Inventors! Astronauts!
What on earth is an astronaut?
No, they're not.
I don't follow.
Well, they're not on Earth, they're in space. In fact, Brother Buzz Aldrin was the second man to walk upon the surface of the moon.
That's the best thing I've heard this evening.
What, that a Mason walked on the moon?
Man on the moon! Amazing!
Why has nobody been to the moon in such a long time?
That's not an 8-year-old's question. That's my question. I want to know. But I think I know. Because we didn't go there, and that's the way it happened.
I'd go to the moon in a nanosecond. The problem is we don't have the technology to do that anymore. We used to, but we destroyed that technology, and it's a painful process to build it back again.
People come out and they've run out of anecdotes, you know, and they just start making stuff up.
Yeah.
Like that Neil Armstrong guy. Have you seen him on the talk shows?
Neil Armstrong, you mean the first man to walk on the moon?
Talk about a fish story.
Yeah.
Man, and they're buying it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man, that's the best idea since they faked the moon landing.
Okay, cut.
Wow, Neil Armstrong. Hey, wait a minute. You're supposed to be on the moon. I just saw it on TV.
Oh, there's a tape delay and with all solar winds.
But don't forget the musicians. Do not forget the musicians.
Authoritarian and totalitarian regimes continue to suppress Freemasonry, afraid of its strong heritage of liberty and equality.
It symbolizes the inevitability of your end.
The British Army had traveling lodges that moved with regiments. Freemasons have served their countries and communities with distinction.
Freemasons met across the Union and Confederate divide to celebrate their common rituals.
And today, Freemasonry remains an active part of military life in many countries.
Freemasonry has burned as a blazing fire through the last 3 centuries. The driving force behind the Royal Society was initiated into Freemasonry.
Prince Edward, Duke of Kent, father of Queen Victoria, and Prince Augustus, Duke of Sussex. The two princes brought their feuding Grand Lodges together and reconciled to be the United Grand Lodge of England.
Kings George IV, William IV, Edward VII, Edward VIII, and George VI were all Freemasons, as were 18 dukes and princes, including the Duke of Edinburgh.
This year, His Royal Highness Prince Edward, the Duke of Kent, celebrates his 50th year as Grand Master of the United Grand Lodge of England.
His Royal Highness was proposed into Freemasonry by the then Grand Master, the Earl of Scarborough.
He was initiated into Royal Alpha Lodge No. 16, an advocate for the craft all over the world. continuing three centuries of distinguished royal tradition at the very heart of English Freemasonry.
To order, brethren, to receive the most worshipful, the Grand Master.
As permanent master of these three lodges, I now call on my deputy masters.
Most worshipful Grand Master.
Most worshipful Grand Master.
Most worshipful Grand Master.
Most worshipful Grand Master, I humbly ask you to complete the initiation of this worthy candidate for Freemasonry.
Adorn our ceremonies and forever remind us of our incomparable heritage, the birth of organized Freemasonry.
Stressing the deep and sincere loyalty and affection felt by the Brethren of the United Grand Lodge of England for their Grand Master.
I had the pleasure of meeting 136 Grand Masters visiting from overseas at Freemasons Hall yesterday. Today, though, we are a meeting of more than 4,000 gathered from all around the world, from our own constitution and beyond. When the global Masonic family comes together to celebrate our past and to renew our own pride and confidence in and enthusiasm for Freemasonry.
I hereby read the text of a letter sent today to Buckingham Palace. May it please your Majesty, we, the representatives of over 200,000 Freemasons under the United Grand Lodge of England, most respectfully express our continuing loyalty to your Majesty's throne and person in this, the 66th year of your long and distinguished reign of His Royal Highness the Duke of Kent as our much-loved and greatly respected Grand Master. We humbly thank God for preserving our order and fervently pray His blessings on your Majesty so that our loyal devotion to your Majesty may long continue. Given at the Royal Albert Hall this 31st day of October, Anno Domini 2017. Her Majesty has been pleased to reply in the following terms. The Queen has asked me to thank you for your kind letter of loyal greetings on behalf of the representatives of the Freemasons under the United Grand Lodge of England, which are being celebrated on the 31st of October at the Royal Albert Hall. Her Majesty appreciated your thoughtfulness in writing as you did.
We leave the Royal Albert Hall even more proud of our ancient institution.
Worldwide, Freemasonry remains as important and relevant as ever. A global society of perhaps 6 million people.
As the globe embraced Freemasonry, enlightenment came.
I may not agree with what you say, but I shall defend to the death your right to say it.
None is more hopelessly enslaved than those who falsely believe they are free.
Coat of arms of Donald Trump. What does it actually represent?
Well, this is rather interesting, actually. This is an arcane Scottish heraldic law providing evidence of Donald Trump's deep Anglophilia, I would say, and also touches upon the royal prerogative. There we have the double-headed eagle representing his Scottish Germanic heritage.
The Masonic chip program uses modern police-approved techniques to create a child identification kit.
And we take fingerprints. We also provide them with a swab for getting a DNA swab. And we also provide them with imprint where they can get an imprint of the child's teeth. So not only does it provide DNA as well as a swab, but it is also a source, if you were using tracking dogs, to provide a scent for the child.
You may be surprised to see who we found using tricks to cover up their license plates.
Apparently, they're law enforcement.
You know, in Hollywood and in the industry and the stuff we do, there's a lot of like insider secrets to keeping your career going, and a lot of insider secrets to making things tick.
That's my line.
Simplified, babe. Let a star do this. That's all!
That's all, folks!
Can I go home now?
Ooh, we can see so clear.